By far, the most common excuse I hear from guys on why they're not dressing sharp. Dude, I'm broke.
I don't have the money.
Man, I got kids and a wife. They're sucking me dry. Well, gentlemen, let's fix the problem.
In today's video, gents, 13 bad habits that keep you poor and how to fix them.
Now, the first bad habit, it's actually more of a belief, and that is that you will be able to do everything yourself through willpower. And I'm about to tell you that your willpower is not very strong. People ask me all the time, oh, in the military, did you learn how to be really strong when it came to willpower? The answer is no. I was put into a system in which it had a very strong will and you conformed to it or you were kicked out. It's the same thing if you want to get a hold of your finances. You've got to understand that your willpower is going to break. So you want to set up systems so you can succeed. Now, the second bad habit is that you ignore the situation. You're that ostrich putting your head in the sand and you're just simply not going to look at it, so it'll go away. No, that's not how it works. In fact, it's going to get a lot worse. You need to bite the bullet and look at the situation. You need to get an assessment of the situation, because if you don't do this, then you're not going to be able to figure things out. You're not going to be able to take actions in the right direction if you don't know where you're at. So you can approach this in a lot of different ways. I'm a big fan of actually just simply writing everything down or putting it into an Excel spreadsheet or going through and actually getting one of those apps. I've talked about Personal Capital, but there's other ones out there. What you want to do is gamify the system. I have found whenever I can see all of my accounts, all of a sudden I'm keeping score, especially one that puts all of my student loans, my credit cards, my bank accounts, everything in one place, my investments, all of a sudden I'm playing along with the game. Next up, pay yourself first. And this can mean a lot of different things. For me as a business owner, I can tell you the first couple of years of my business, I was not paying myself. I would take money out of the accounts, but that was only if we had money. And oftentimes we did not. But here's the thing, whether it be the money you have coming in, whether it be your business or if you're working for somebody else, you're going to find a way to spend the money. So you need to spend and pay yourself first. For a lot of people, this is simply putting money to the side. For me as a business owner, when I started paying myself a regular salary, I was amazed, but my business was able to make it up because I realized I had paid a consultant a lot of money and I realized I was paying her more than I had paid myself. And I found a way to make that money. So all of a sudden, when you're paying yourself, you're going to be able to find a way, you're going to make it happen. And that right there, I have found works for me and has enabled me now to start taking a much better salary. And my wife is very happy about that. Now, the next bad habit you need to break is you need to be measuring your progress. And this is something that happens over time because nothing gets you more excited about continuing to do something than seeing progress. I mean, when you go to the gym, you're starting to lift more weights. You get excited to go to the gym because you see this progress. You want to say the same things with paying down student loans, with paying off credit cards. And the best way to do this is to focus in on one bill that has the highest interest rate and like a laser, focus all your extra money there. I don't know, maybe it's an extra $25 a month, but you can find a way to apply that and all of a sudden start pushing that down. And then the money you save there, you go and you laser focus somewhere else. But remember, what is measured is what is improved. So measure that progress. Now, this next bad habit, this one's really hard to break, and that is preconceived notions about money taught to us by our parents. Because basically, most of our parents did not know how to manage money. Some of you guys were lucky. You had great parents that taught you a lot. My parents, they had gone through bankruptcies. They lived paycheck to paycheck. My mom worked three jobs, but it was something she never saved money. And she always, you know, mismanaged it. They smoked, they drank. There were just a lot of things going on. They just weren't good with money. And they taught me what they could be. You can't teach somebody something if you don't know how to do it yourself. Find your Yoda. Find someone that you connect with who can show you the path, who can show you the way. I've talked about my friend Jeff Rose, and I'll link to his channel down in the description of my video. This guy, Wealth Hacker, absolutely love what he's doing. He actually served in the Army, good friend of mine. He is helping people online, but there are so many other people out there. There isn't going to be one person that you're going to take everything from, and that's it. I really like to go out there and cherry pick and bring it together to find the best lessons for me. The next bad habit, you're not sharpening your mind. You're not reading the right books. You are not getting smarter when it comes to finance. Imagine going into a fight with a dull blade. What's going to happen? You're going to hit somebody and you're just going to piss them off versus cutting them in half. Now, if you've got a sharp blade, you've got a sharp end, you're going to be able to have to do some damage on the battlefield. With a modern day battlefield, guess what, guys? It's using your mind and being able to go out there and intellectually make things happen. So you want to be able to, hey, be reading. Richest Man in Babylon, great book. Right here, I talked about Ramit Sethi, I Will Teach You to Be Rich, excellent book. Jeff Rose, Soldier of Finance, great read. Again, gentlemen, make sure you're sharpening that mind. The next bad habit that's keeping you poor is you have to keep up with the Joneses. And I know, coming from a channel that talks about improving your style, going out there and buying Rolexes, nice suits. But here's the deal, is I always say, never spend money that you don't have. If you have spent $200,000 in your education and you've only spent $200 or maybe even $1,000 on your wardrobe, I think that's an issue. Because if you've got so much up here and you've invested so much, you do need to put your best foot forward. So if you're a lawyer in New York City, or if you're maybe a consultant in Chicago, you're in the entertainment industry in LA, I do think that you should be spending a bit on your wardrobe when you're making good money. But if you're not, there are still ways to actually look great and not spend a whole lot of money and not go into credit card debt or the poorhouse. The key here is, don't spend a lot of money just thinking you got to keep up with people by buying that new iPhone, by going out there and getting a new car every couple years. That takes me to the next bad habit, which is justifying expenses. And as human beings, we find a way to justify everything. Human beings are very good at this, but just because you justify it does not mean that it is correct. The point here, don't overspend when looking to impress others. Yes, first impressions are important, but you can do it on a budget. Now, this next bad habit is the what the hell effect. Yes, this is a documented effect whenever basically you start to spend money. And all of a sudden you're like, what the hell? I've already started. I may as well keep going with this. This happens all the time when people start to diet. They take a bite of a donut. I shouldn't have been eating this. Might as well eat the entire thing. You don't have to eat the entire thing. And whenever, you know, you go out and you spend a little bit of extra money, you don't have to say, I'm already using the credit card. Might as well throw this on it and throw that on it. No. The what the hell effect is real, and you need to be careful of it. Now, the next bad habit is credit cards. Notice, whenever we spend money on credit cards, the pain is a lot less than if you spend cold hard cash. So how do you overcome the bias with credit cards that you're more likely to spend? For me, it is the use of debit cards. Now, I use debit cards and credit cards, but with debit cards, I find that I immediately know that money's coming out. It's a small, very small thing, but it's a reminder that this money is going out of the account immediately. And with credit cards, I have all of my credit cards set up to pay in full at the end of the month. But most of the time I'm using my debit card, especially for personal expenses. And when you can, try to use cash, because it's the most painful of all and will really make you rethink, do I really want to spend money here? Now, this next bad habit is actually related to economics. And that is, as your income increases, you are more likely to spend more. And it's oftentimes the small things, because maybe you've been buying a really cheap toothpaste or really cheap shampoo. So you're getting nicer toothpaste, nicer shampoo. Now, this makes sense if it's a better toothpaste. Maybe you've got, and I think for something, okay, I would justify that. But be careful of other things, because all of a sudden you think, you know what? I need a nicer apartment. I need a nicer car. And all of a sudden your expenses rise to meet your income. You got to be careful of this. The smartest people that I've heard, they've actually set up systems so that, again, they're paying themselves first and they're actually living at the same level they were when they were making half as much money. And instead they're aggressively saving money. Now, the next bad habit is the present bias. And this is that we feel something given to us right now is going to be, you know, right now spending the money, I'm okay with not having the money in the future. The future will take care of itself. This is something we all fall into. For me, what I try to set up, again, saving systems. So every single month, money's putting into my Roth IRA. Why? Because a Roth IRA is actually set up so that you can't touch it without penalty till you're 65. Or maybe if you want to use it for education purposes. Point being is, it's difficult. I've also set up multiple savings accounts. I've chosen a certain bank for certain. I've got multiple banks. And with that, I've got it. So the money flows into these savings accounts that have no card. I have to actually physically go into the bank to access them. So guess what? All of those barriers protect me from stupid me, who stupid me would want to go off and splurge a lot, spend all that money on watches, which I'll somehow justify, or spend it on fragrances. I will find a way to spend the money. I fall into this like anyone else. And by setting up those barriers, I'm able to protect money from myself. Now, this next bad habit doesn't maybe seem like a bad habit, but that's being over-focused on savings and not focusing in on income. Think of it like American football. You've got offense and you've got defense. And if you're always focused in on the defense, that's where you put 99.9% of your resources. Yeah, you're going to have a great defense. You're going to save up a lot of money. But if you're only making a couple $1,000s per month, the most that you'll ever be able to save, even if you had 100% savings rate, is $2,000 a month. But here's the deal. How about actually go out there and look for another job? You've got some great skills. You haven't actually shopped your market out. All of a sudden, you find a new job for $4,000 a month. And guess what? You just got a huge pay raise. And that's what so many people don't think about is the offensive side. Going and looking to change your income, maybe changing careers, going into a different industry that pays a lot more for the same amount of work, or just simply do some work on the side. And if you want to learn how to do that, I've got you covered with this video right here, how to make an extra $1,000 in the next week. I made this video a while back. It's got over 1 million views because it's got actually really good information, or maybe I'm just so darn good looking. I'll let you be the judge. Point being, guys, is go check out this video. Great information about how to make more money, and it's linked to a playlist that goes into a number of other great finance videos. So go check it out.